Thank you so much, Chairman, sir. Firstly, I'd like to commend the Health Minister for bringing this bill in good faith, which I can appreciate. However, it hasn't been minutely thought through, and it becomes our bounden duty to express the loopholes that exist, and I'm hoping the Health Minister would consider them. Sir, terminating a pregnancy for a woman to make that decision is mentally, emotionally, and a very physically impacting decision that she takes in her life. And for her, who is an advanced stage of pregnancy, and a stage where she knows there is life inside her womb, for her to take that decision is a difficult one indeed. For her to run across to various medical boards that we are talking about constituting, which has three doctors and some state representatives, I think is extremely demeaning to her, is invasion of her privacy, invasion of her choice, and also creating more bureaucratic hurdles than needed at a time when she needs to take that decision. I would have appreciated it. Everybody is going on talking about it being a rights-based approach. I'm sorry, this bill is not a rights-based approach. It's a needs-based approach. And that is where we are faltering, where we are not allowing a woman to make that choice. My colleague in the parliament, she said something like, mahilaon ko sochna chahiye ki un mahilaon ka jo jinke saath dushkarm hote hain, wo un bachon ko pet mein rakhti hain. मैं वही उनको बताना चाहती हूं कि वो महिला क्यों नहीं निर्णय ले सकती है और क्यों उसको मेडिकल बोर्ड के पास जाकर पहले परमिशन लेनी पड़ेगी कि हाँ, ये पहले मुझे परमिशन दो, फिर मैं अपने कोख में जो बच्चा पल रहा है उसको खत्म करूं. बहुत ही दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण डिसीजन होता है, दर्दनाक डिसीजन होता है. साथ ही साथ मैं ये भी कहना चाहूंगी सर, मेडिकल बोर्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूट करना, स्पेशलिस्ट डॉक्टर्स की सुविधा, इन तीन में आपने तीन स्पेशलिस्ट बताए हैं, हर राज्य में, हर रूरल एरियाज में नहीं पाए जाते हैं, वो भी दिक्कतें सामने आने वाली हैं. साथ ही साथ बजटरी कंस्ट्रेंट्स होते हैं हर राज्य के. बजटरी कंस्ट्रेंट्स के साथ साथ प्रैक्टिकलिटी होती है कि ये इम्प्लीमेंटेबल है या नहीं है. एंड आई जस्ट वांट टू ब्रिंग इन सम डेटा विच श्रीमती श्री अमीबेन याग्निक हैज ऑलरेडी स्पोकन, मिस अमीबेन याग्निक हैज ऑलरेडी मैंशन. 78% जो अबॉर्शन होते हैं हमारे देश में आउटसाइड ऑफ हॉस्पिटल फैसिलिटीज होते हैं, हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज होते हैं, जो कि कभी कभी इलीगल भी होते हैं पर अनसेफ भी होते हैं, और वो मेटर्नल मोर्टेलिटी रेट बताती है. कोविड लॉकडाउन के अंतर्गत तो बहुत ही ऐसे केस हुए होंगे जिनमें हॉस्पिटल्स तक जाने की सुविधा नहीं मिली होगी. एक रीसेंट स्टडी आई थी लॉ स्कूल की, एक रीसेंट स्टडी है जिसमें कहते हैं कि 80% से ज़्यादा स्पेशलिटी डॉक्टर्स कम्युनिटी हेल्थ सेंटर्स में नहीं मिलते हैं. 80% In certain states like Gujarat and Tamil Nadu, there is near complete absence in the availability of certain specialists in rural areas. In places like Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Mizoram, and Sikkim, there is a glaring 100% shortfall in availability of pediatricians, which is a need in the medical board that we are talking about. Sir, poor public health infrastructure and absence of specialists across the country have also meant that most of these abortions do not happen in public hospitals but in private hospitals, which adds to the expense burden of the women. So my only request through your chair, sir, would be to either amend this bill and make it like we have created some progressive laws when we created this law in 1971, and we seek an amendment now. It should become a model for the world to follow rather than pushing a bill through in a hurry and regretting at leisure. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.